It's been exactly 1 year, 15 days, and 0 hours since I was sworn in as director of the NCI. This first anniversary is an opportunity for me to take stock. What are my ambitions, and hopefully shared ambitions of all of us, for the next 5 years? The first is to think that we'll have some answers to some of my favorite provocative questions within the next few years. Some obvious questions I'd like to know some answers to in the next few years are, first, how does obesity contribute to the incidence and mortality of cancer? Why do some commonly used drugs like aspirin appear to reduce the risk of cancer, both incidence and mortality? How do some neurological diseases like Parkinson's disease, for example, confer protection against cancer? The second ambition is actually the most obvious, but it has to be stated because it is incredibly important, and that is I'd like to see over the next couple of years a much more substantial incorporation of our molecular understanding of cancer into all phases of cancer control. I expect to see a pretty dramatic revolution in epidemiology, defining cancers not simply pathologically under the microscope, but by genetic subsets. I expect to see molecular tools brought more forcefully into the realm of cancer diagnosis. Hopefully, in the very near future, we'll be talking about ways to discriminate among early lesions and precancerous lesions that may have malignant potential, again, by defining molecular changes in those lesions. What I'd like to see happen over the next couple of years is accepted integration of research on cancer into the menu of what constitutes a global health initiative for this country. So this means not simply treating more people in poor countries for cancer. It means improving our traditional epidemiology by which we determine which cancers are most common in which countries, broadening the strategies for prevention in developing countries, identifying opportunities and the means for affordable treatment. The fourth general ambition is the only mention I'm going to make about money, but I think we can get better prepared for the need to adapt to budget uncertainties. Now, this raises some NIH-wide issues, perhaps these are U.S. government-wide issues, about our contract with grantee institutions. Should we use more so-called R21 grants? Some would argue they encourage exploration and more innovative proposals. I think we need to think a little bit about the numbers and sizes and shapes of our multi-investigator awards. I strongly believe in the need to encourage teamwork between investigators within and between institutions, but also some awards to our most outstanding investigators, and I mean both new and more experienced investigators, grants of 7 to 10 years for a few percent to decrease the burden on the review system. I want to be sure that we're paying attention to our training programs because our training programs are one of our best means for recruiting people to the intramural NIH. I would like to believe that over the next few years, we can develop a greater sense of public trust, that is, trust by the public in the idea that NCI is making progress against cancer, is spending its funds wisely, is acting in the public interest from many points of view with respect to the way in which we conduct science. I am able to bear witness, and some others of you in the room can as well, to the remarkable transformation of cancer research that has occurred over the last 40 years or so. Need to get out there and talk about the depth of the change that's occurred in this field from a time 40 years ago when we didn't have a clue about how a normal cell became a cancer cell to a time when virtually everything we do to understand cancer cells becomes a topic for contemplation about new ways to diagnose, treat, and prevent cancer, have a responsibility to make that change known to the public. That is the only way in which we'll be able to ensure the public's commitment to what we at the NIH and the NCI do. Thank you very much for your attention today.